Reunion Arena set for the second quarterfinal of the day. SMU and Texas A&M. And again, to call it for you, Bill Land and Jimmy Dykes.
Thank you very much, Dave. Let's look at the starting lineups as we get ready to tip it off here. For SMU, Gatewood the leading scorer. Boyd, Van Beveren, some muscle in the middle. Dorner and Matthews, we talked about at the guard. For A&M, Johnson, McGinnis, Murray, Henderson, and of course David Edwards, the star of this club. Don't be surprised that Wilbert doesn't start. He's only started one game, and that was the last one, as Tony Barone was looking for anything to get him going. But he is normally a guy who comes off the bench, so that is nothing to be alarmed about if you're just catching the eggs for the first time. And the tip goes out of bounds. It will go to Texas A&M, as A&M at 17-9, 10-4 in the league. SMU 6-20, 3-11 in conference play. As you look at Tony Barone, the head coach of Texas A&M, regardless of what happens in this tournament, he has done a super job in rebuilding the Aggie program. Boyd with a steal, as it was intended for Henderson. And it won't go on the long shot from Matthews. Here come the Aggies again. SMU, the worst shooting team in the league, 41%. They've got to hit some outside shots to loosen up things. Murray with a miss. Gatewood after the rebound from Van Beveren. Aggies shoot at 45%. Matthews, Dorner. Gatewood on the baseline. Back out to Matthews as A&M opens man-to-man. 15 on the shot clock for the Mustangs of Southern Methodist. Boyd, Dorner, 9 on the shot clock. Dorner against Edwards, his own, and SMU with a 2-0 lead and 18:56 to play in the half. Edwards for the Aggies, down low to Johnson, triple team. McGinnis fighting, Johnson again, and knocked away by Boyd, cleared by Gatewood.
See SMU opening up in a motion offense. That's a good job right there, taking the ball inside. The defense concentrated on Boyd and threw the skip pass to Gatewood. That's a tough matchup for A&M, James Gatewood.
Edwards got it knocked away. A couple of blocks early going for the Mustangs. They're up 4-0 with the basketball.
SMU would like to keep this thing in a half-court situation at both ends. The transition game favors A&M. A&M talked about in their press conference, they practiced it yesterday, they need to be more aggressive and get this tempo picked up.
18 minutes to go, first half. A&M yet to break on the board. Murray for the three. And again on the backboards, SMU doing a nice job of hustling. And the foul is called on Damon Johnson. As coming in is Joe Wilbert, their leading scorer, 14 points a game. Look, the first 11 compared to the last three.
And look at that field goal percentage, 61%, then he's dropped off to 18. This is a critical time for A&M. The three guys that just went and sat down, they were a little tentative, not with playing with a lot of fire. Joe Wilbert has to set the tone for the Aggies here in the next couple of minutes.
Wilbert, in case you haven't followed the story, had an eye injury suffered in a game against TCU. He's going great guns, carried this team for about six games, and in that game he did, even though he played 18 minutes before he got hurt. And after that, he has not been the same. Gatewood makes the bucket. And the story is that he has suffered double vision, then it has been fine, and Tony Barone believes he's okay. Wilbert says he's okay at times, and they're all kind of wondering what's going on as the shot is missed by Henderson. And at this point, we saw him against the Baylor in part of the three-game losing streak. He certainly wasn't okay that night, Jimmy.
No, his game is all about taking it to the paint and making strong moves to the basket, and he was very tentative, kind of protective of that eye, I thought. And again, like we talked about in the open, he's got to come out this afternoon if he's okay and get things untracked and take his game to a higher level than he's been playing at.
Matthews had it taken away, and now to Smith, he'll bring it back around quickly the other side. Michael Smith, who has not seen a lot of playing time, trying to run the show right now. And inside, foul is called.
This is why Gatewood is so difficult to defend. At 6'8", he can catch it and put the ball on the floor and create his own shot. See the little ball fake right there? Then the draw through move gets the shot up. Again, those perimeter shots fall for SMU just enough to make A&M extend their defense and not collapse on James Gatewood. That's trouble for the Aggies.
Gatewood got the foul there a moment ago. His first, team's first. Here comes Boyd after the steal. Let Gatewood couldn't get it to rattle in. They're letting him go here early. Here is Smith in place of David Edwards. Inside, the bucket is good. Wilbert gets a basket, and any basket early is a confidence builder for Joe Wilbert, the junior from Bryan, Texas, averaging 14 a game. Well, it took the Aggies almost 4 minutes, 3:50, to get on the board. But they're only down by four, as SMU is struggling too. Boyd, Van Beveren with the follow. Raymond Van Beveren averages 5 points and five boards a game, gets his first two. Here's Lance Broderson. And it's a charge against Broderson. And David Edwards on the bench.
Obviously, Tony Barone not happy with the play of a couple of his starters early. Going to make a point and set him down and let him watch for a little bit.
He's coming back. We'll be back.
It's a silver time. It's a silver place. It's a silver setting at a silver base.
Shipping a package to Omaha, that's child's play. Try customs in Shanghai, the Peruvian Andes, parking in Paris, sandstorms in Cairo, the 400 dialects of India, an address between Czech and Slovakia. That demands local know-how. DHL people are the locals. DHL, we'll take it from here. Omaha, that's a milk run.
Because most of our flights are short, this is what our meals look like on Southwest Airlines. It's also what our fares look like. Southwest Airlines, it's just plain smart. Frequent flyers on most airlines are thousands of miles from a free trip. But on Southwest Airlines, our Company Club frequent flyer members are only 8 short round trips away. Southwest Airlines Company Club, the shortest route to free trips.
Texas A&M on the short side, 8-2. Welcome back, everyone. Bill Ann, along with Jimmy Dykes, Dave Barnett with you here on Pride Basketball, Dr. Pepper Southwest Conference Classic. And SMU with an early 8-2 lead. David Edwards comes back in the ballgame for Texas A&M. Tony Barone obviously saw something he didn't like in the first possession or two and pulled his star out. McGinnis with a steal, but he was out of bounds. But that's the kind of pressure that A&M would like to exert.
Yeah, if you're struggling on the offensive end and you want to get some things happening, extend your defense to a full court situation. They got the turnover, just stepped out of bounds. But I like the coaching move by Tony Barone.
Dorner, the pinch near the timeline, and gets it over to Matthews. Edwards with a steal. McGinnis, and that is what A&M can do when Edwards is in there to ignite things. 218 steals in his career, the best in Texas A&M history. He's also their all-time leader in assists with 562.
Well, Matthews looks to me a little shaky out there at the point, handling that ball with David Edwards hounding him at ball level.
Gatewood got the pick from Jessen and then drains it.
You know, I like the one dribble that time that Gatewood used to get himself in rhythm and in sync offensively. Got himself gathered and jumped up and stroked it.
He's got 6 of their 10. A&M counters. Murray. 10-6. SMU by 4. 14:38 remaining. First half action here in our second game. Texas Tech awaiting the winner of this one after disposing of Houston in the opening quarterfinal. And the foul is called on Henderson. Chuck, the senior from Houston, picks up his first, team's third. SMU with one foul. And it's Pony basketball. Jessen having trouble, got it into Gatewood. Dorner for three. On the glass, McGinnis picked it off. Wilbert couldn't handle the short one. Not an easy shot, but certainly very makeable. Matthews misses the tray. Henderson, now Edwards. He put it up a gear, but lost control and taken away by Jessup. Gatewood for the slam. No, and that would have counted. Great effort by Gatewood to even get the shot off as the foul is called against Henderson.
15, Chuck Henderson, his second team straight.
Great hustle by Henderson getting back. Watch Wilbert right here. He's going to position himself to receive it for an easy 2 points. Breakdown defensive there by the Mustangs. You've got to cover guys better than that in transition. And he just misses the shot. The defender sailed by him and maybe distracted him a little bit. But there comes a point in time from a coaching standpoint where you've got to hold your players accountable. You can only do so much and get a guy a wide open layup. We saw Damon Johnson miss some late in their loss at A&M the last time we had him. And there comes a point where the players have to step up and start making plays for you.
Yeah, yesterday in practice, Tony Baroni at one point became so frustrated as Wilbert was struggling. He said, dunk the basketball if you're that close. And the next time down, he missed the dunk. And it's just been that way.
Yeah.
And Tony is, if you heard him with Dave Barnett earlier on the halftime interviews, mentioned that he definitely thinks it's psychological now as much as there is anything else with it. Murray, 11-6 as Gatewood has got 7 of the 11 to pace SMU. He averages 13 a game, and he's doing his job here. Murray, Brown couldn't get the rebound, or the Boyd, and it goes out of bounds. It'll go back to Texas A&M. And checking in as you look at Tony Baroni, he's finally gotten smart and said, why wear a tie? The coat is always gone. The tie is usually gone very quickly. Well, he's going to be comfortable here today. Henderson couldn't hit the three.
Well, Henderson's the type of three-point shooter that has to be spotted up and have his feet set. He was moving a little bit that time, but that's how you need to guard Chuck Henderson. Make him move, make him do something he doesn't want to.
Matt Timmy in the ball game for SMU just handled the ball. Now to Matthews, 13:09 to go in the half. Boyd hits the three. Chris Boyd, a 6'5 freshman from California, averaging 7.5 points a game. And a foul called on Edwards' way to the hoop. Biggest lead here for SMU of 8. Matthews picks up a foul. His first, team second. Edwards for the tray and gets it. David Edwards, a 25% three-point shooter, averaging 12 points a game, all-conference first team, all-defensive first team. And he gets his first bucket. Jessen hits a three the other way. Man.
Well, McGinnis is going to be coming out of the game. Tony Baroni told us yesterday in the three losses he's had, he was more concerned with the defensive breakdowns. There, Jessen is a streak shooter, and McGinnis was not close to him when he caught the ball. And I would bet McGinnis will be checking out the next dead ball situation.
Edwards slapped it away out of bounds. It'll go again to SMU. And coming into the ball game, Matthews takes the seat as Dorner is back in. And also checking in for Texas A&M, Corey Henderson.
There's our boy McGinnis. See, Tony Baroni went over and told him, you've got to guard that guy. And I like solid basketball teams, and Tony Baroni coaches a solid game. He understands the importance of defense, and he doesn't like those breakdowns.
Wilbert kicked it away to Edwards, almost went out of play. Edwards against Dorner. Wilbert, and that ball was knocked away in the cylinder. It'll count as Boyd got a touch on it. And boy, if you're John Shoemate, you're saying the way Wilbert's going, guys, don't give him any chance to recover. Don't foul him. Don't give him any cheapies, because the guy's wondering right now if he can get it together or not.
You know, SMU physically wore out A&M in that victory at Moody Coliseum just a few short days ago. And A&M is a physical basketball team, so that tells you that they're not playing with the same aggressive style they have early in the year.
What are you talking about physical?
Yeah, look at both teams right there getting on the floor. Man, you love that. That is something you can coach. A loose ball drill, talking about guys getting down on the floor and getting after it. You can coach it, because if they don't get on the floor and get down there and get dirty for you, you sit them on the bench.
Effort is never a problem for the Aggies of Tony Baroni. It's 17-11. They trail by 6.
If you know the power of rock and roll, then get ready for the ride of your life.
And when you really, really need it the most, that's when rock and
Bad Out of Hell 2, Back into Hell. New from Meatloaf on MCA compact discs and cassettes.
Excuse me, Sonny!
When the NBA is whooping it up, there's a lot of Gatorade going down. Scientifically tested, athletically proven Gatorade.
March Madness returns to Dallas March 9th through the 12th at the Dr. Pepper Southwest Conference Classic and Hoopla Festival. See the best of the SWC as all eight men's and women's teams battle for the 1994 championship title. And backed by popular demand is the Hoopla Festival, featuring live entertainment, food, games, and lots of fun. Stake your claim now to the best seats in the house by calling the SWC ticket hotline, 1-800-800-7928. Don't miss the Hoopla in Dallas at the Dr. Pepper Southwest Conference Classic.
SMU up by 6, 17-11, and now this message from Continental Airlines.
Travel arranged through Continental. One airline can make a difference. One pass lets you earn free travel faster than any other airline. That's the difference on Continental.
Texas A&M has hit 5 of 17, just 29%, Jimmy. SMU 7 of 16 for 44%. The boards are even at 10 each here in the early going.
We talked about the three losses for A&M. Their defense wasn't as solid as Tony Broning would like it, and they only shot 40% from the field.
Jessen pulled everything. Foul called on A&M. It's on Henderson. Corey Henderson averaging 2 points a game. Junior out of Houston Lee High School picks up the foul. And that is the fifth A&M foul. His first. Matt Timmy. Wilbert, nice defensive effort to get in his face. But SMU the board, and now Boyd, he hits a floater.
Boy, I really like him. He's given some solid minutes and worked his way into the starting lineup as a freshman. He's going to be a complete basketball player by the time he's through for John Shoemake.
He's got five, and this one a tie-up, and it'll go the other way. As, well, tempers are a little hot right now, including the head coach, John Shoemake. He's having a little conversation with David Edwards. SMU basketball. Well, this is a game that both teams want desperately. Obviously, for SMU, it's the only chance to extend the season. And I think A&M feels that way, too, that they certainly couldn't get in the NCAA unless they win this tournament. They're not going to take any chances. And even for the NIT, they feel that they need a couple more victories.
Yeah, they probably need to get to the finals. Very difficult to work your way in the NCAA when you have tailed off at the end. That selection committee looks at things like that.
Tony Broney Jr. with the foul, his first, as he just entered the game a moment ago. And what did Dad think about it?
Well, he doesn't like it. You got to play solid defense without fouling, and one way SMU can hang in this ball game, they don't shoot the ball well down from the field, but you can put them on the free throw stripe, you could be in some serious trouble.
Edwards on the run for the Aggies. Broderson, Henderson. High post, that's Broderson, and Lance Broderson. He's a banger, 6'6 sophomore from Naperville, Illinois, averaging 5 points, 3 boards a contest, and it's 19-13. First bucket today. Boyd looked up for a second and lost the basketball. Wilbert will go to the line for a pair. He was going for the slam on the feed from Edwards. Gatewood, his second personal foul, and they can ill afford to let James Gatewood get in foul trouble. SMU, I'm speaking of. Leading scorer, leading rebounder, eighth best in the league and 7 boards a game. And at the line will be Joe Wilbert for Texas A&M with 4 points tonight. Afternoon, I should say. Tonight we got 2 more quarterfinal games coming up here as the league champ Texas will go after TCU, and don't forget Baylor and Rice to close things out right here on Prime from the Dr. Pepper Southwest Classic.
Talked about Broderson being a banger, and he jumped up and knocked down about a 12-foot jump shot. A&M in their loss to SMU missed about a dozen 15-foot elbow jump shots, and you've got to be able to knock those down. That SMU defense is collapsing in that lane right now, and if you can't hit the 12 to 15 foot medium range jump shot against the Ponies, you're going to struggle on the offensive end.
You saw Wilbert's percentage from the floor. He's 64 from the line. Makes it 19-15, a half dozen for Joe Wilbert. Well, for a guy the last three games who has really struggled, that's a positive. Now a foul called, and something wrong with Wilbert's eye this time, but it's tears.
Yeah,
he can't believe it. He could a little crying.
Well, SMU made a mistake of inbounding that basketball against the full court pressure towards the corner, and Wilbert had a severe trap on him. Just got caught with a hand check. But I still, early in the ball game, I like A&M in the full court pressing situations. That's going to make them play more aggressive, which they have to do against SMU, because athletically they're better. So when you have them out athleted up and down that lineup, you need to be the forcer and the aggressor at all times.
And that's certainly a point that Tony Barone drove home yesterday. Coming back in the ball game is Chuck Henderson, replacing Barone Jr.
Chuck Henderson, number 15, returning to the game.
20-15, SMU by five with 10:27 to go first half. Dorner at the line, and he hits this one. Don't expect him to miss off. An 83% free throw shooter, Troy Dorner.
Yeah, he can really shoot the basketball, shooting 50% from the three-point stripe in Southwest Conference play is Dorner, and he has played now in 82 consecutive games. Very durable. You see Tony Barone signaling that number one out-of-bounds play, so we'll get a look at it and see what it is. If other coaches playing tonight are scouting at home from the TV, they can draw it. It's a double screen for Henderson at the top.
You charge for your scouting service?
Wilbert, and a charge is called.
Don't you know that frustrates Tony, because here he's told Wilbert, take it to the basket, get aggressive. Wilbert does just that, and he picks up another personal foul. His second. Ags having trouble getting untracked here in this second quarterfinal game. Timmy, and SMU has played well so far. Jessen. And now Gatewood, Dorner off the screen and could not drain it. Henderson gives it up to Edwards. Broderson got tripped going down the floor, and Edwards had to bounce around him. Lost control of it. Last touch by SMU, apparently, though, to go back to Texas A&M.
Broderson is one of those kind of guys. Every time I've seen him play, he is on the floor more than any other player. Now, that time he got tripped, it wasn't his fault. But he's just one of those kind of guys that's always just sliding around and banging up and getting bruised and cut. And there's nothing real pretty or finesse about Lance Broderson. He's just a worker that's effective.
If he had an open layup, he'd go find someone that he could bounce off of first, I think. Here's Henderson for the three, and he gets it. Chuck Henderson, fifth best in the league at 41% from three-point range, and that's how he gets his first points. 21-18, Aggies back within three. They had trailed by eight at 19-11. Matthews and Henderson all over him. Corey. They extend the defensive pressure. Now they back off a bit. Gatewood.
Great job by Van Beveren coming up to be the outlet guy. A lot of times that center position, when the defensive pressure is applied, he's got to break up and get that basketball.
Well, A&M not known for the threes, only 30% on the year. That is eighth in an eight-team league. Let's take a look at the one a moment ago, though.
Well, see, Broderson right there, we've talked about how he's just kind of out there making things happen. He frees up the three-point shot by Henderson. He's one of those kind of guys in the scouting report, Lance Broderson. He's their best picker. Okay, that tells you right there about his game. He's not going to shoot the three. He's not going to make great plays on you, but he's their best screener. He rebounds. He's on the floor. He's just kind of out there all the time, just messing things up with the other team.
Henderson, who got his third foul, takes a seat now as Barone Jr. back in with 9:07 to go in the half, and Tony not real happy. Valuable player on the bench. And then another foul, this time against Chris Jessen. And that's what's a little difficult to handle, I think, coaching or playing, is that they really let things go, Jimmy, the first 6 or 7 minutes, and now there's been a couple excuse me's the last 2 minutes.
Well, if that trend continues, you got to communicate with your players and adjust to the way the game's being played.
Henderson, Corey can't hit it, and winning the battle, the basketball, Dorner for SMU. He lost control. Van Beveren spots up Jessen. Matthews. 8:41 remaining in the half, 22-18. Ponies by four. Matthews for the three, and SMU, the second best three-point shooting team in the league at 35, and he gets one to make it 25-18. Matthews makes it a seven-point game. Wilbert steps out. That's a long shot for Joe Wilbert now. 56% shooter, second in the conference. 60, as Jimmy mentioned, in league play. He's got 8 points.
Well, that's that 15-16-foot range jump shot that they did not knock down in Moody Coliseum. If they can get that shot to fall, it's just a matter of time before that A&M inside attack starts taking over.
Edwards. Back out to Broderson. Henderson feeds Wilbert. Wilbert felt the pressure. The shot wouldn't fall, though. 25-20, Ponies by five. They got the first six in this game and have not trailed. Dorner, nice little move to the hoop, and it's a seven-point contest.
You know what I like about Dorner from a guard standpoint? He can take that ball to the and jump up and shoot at the top of defenses at 6'2".
He's got seven. Van Beveren swats it away from Broderson. Well, last year, SMU was the regular season champ and got beat by TCU in the opening game. Now they're trying to do the favor to the second place team and make a surprise of their own, and it's 29-20. Edwards got bumped, no call. SMU basketball. Three subs coming in for the Aggies. They're in trouble. Down by nine, 7:06 to go in the half.
Hi, I'm Jim Clark with RE/MAX Realtors. During the past 10 years, I've helped over 300 families like Frank and Carol buy and sell their homes in the Round Rock area. If you're thinking of buying or selling, put my experience to work for you. Call Jim Clark, 255-9300.
Crime Stoppers is stepping up their campaign against local crime, and your participation is crucial to the success of this program. Crime Stoppers pays cash rewards for information leading to the arrest and indictment of suspects in featured crime. Crime Stoppers is building a safer community with your help.
Hello, Amco man.
That was Zsa Zsa in Amco's first commercial almost 30 years ago. Since then, hundreds of commercials told you Amco fixes any problem coast to coast. At Amco, there's no monkeying around. The toughest transmission jobs are better than fixed. They're like new. Amco, America's number one transmission specialist for 30 years.
For all your transmission needs, visit your locally owned and operated Amco in Round Rock, just off I-35 at exit 251, or call 244-2080.
Then, give some more. No cuts, no glory, no title. Texas Boys 5A Basketball Championship, Saturday on HSE.
SMU 29-20 over Texas A&M, but there is some good news for A&M. It's Joe Wilbert.
Watch SMU with their motion offense. Not a lot of screening, a lot of movement. Then Matthews just pops out to the perimeter. His defender kind of got hung up on some motion right there and just knocks the bottom out of a three. But watch Joe Wilbert on the other end. This is the shot that Broderson and Wilbert and Damon Johnson, those guys have to be able to hit that elbow jump shot right there to free up that play on the block later on in this game.
Joe Wilbert and the Aggies down by nine. 29-20, 7:06 remaining. A&M shooting just 32%, SMU 46%. SMU's at 3 of 7 in the three-point category. Matthews for the two. That'll pass, he'd say. Van Beveren can't finish. Kept it alive, and it comes to David Edwards. Battle inside going on, and they got a call on Matt Timmy. I was going to say, he and Wilbert really working at it for position.
Fellas charged to number 44.
John Shoemake looking to even his college coaching record at 130-130 with a win today. Let's forget about the 3 years he spent at Grand Canyon out in Arizona. Wilbert. Rebound Timmy. Wilbert passed up a similar shot that he made a moment ago.
Yeah, and he looked good shooting that shot, too. He had good form. Jumped up there with some confidence. I'd like to see him take that shot instead of taking it into traffic right now.
29-20, SMU's biggest lead of the ball game. Timmy, 16 on the shot clock. Van Beveren wide open as they missed the steal attempt, A&M. And it's a double-digit lead now. Wilbert, he was going back to Murray, and Edwards came over to quickly come up with it. David Edwards, 16 on the shot clock. Wilbert, fade away, no. Timmy, the rebound. SMU leading by 11. Matthews, Edwards, what a job coming from behind, and then the pass back to Smith, and Matthews says thank you. It's all SMU right now.
Yeah, that's a sign early that things just aren't going your way. David Edwards with a great hustle play, saved the ball, threw it back in, and then right to Matthews, who got the 2 points. And now David Edwards, now he's the guy that can control the tempo of this game. When he gets on fire, he can distribute, he can rebound, he can shoot it down. He's got to have a big afternoon. He and Wilbert have got to carry this team right now.
He's got six, and now with a steal as he literally took it right away from Allen. Edwards got the bucket, so the last five for the Aggies and Edwards, and it's a 33-25 ball game. Eight for David Edwards. Allen to Timmy. Matthews. Boy, SMU's done a nice job. They've been very disciplined. A&M trying to turn up the defensive heat. It's been working. But a foul called on Smith. Jimmy Smith. Let's take a look at the work of David Edwards.
Well, he does it on both ends. Watch the quick hands right here. Strips Allen the basketball, and like all point guards, pushes that ball up until the defense stops him. Look, no one stopped his penetration yet, so take it to the paint. And the good athletic play to hang in the air and get the shot off and gets it to drop. And that guy, he's had a lot of career triple doubles. Now you talk about a guy that's only 5'9 getting triple doubles, that's not easy to do. So he's scoring, he's getting assists, and he's rebounding. That's what's amazing, is the rebound that guy comes up with.
Three triple doubles, and the only three in A&M history, owned by David Edwards, two this season, one last year, as Timmy at the free throw line to make it a 34-25 ball game.
No, he's second to Hakeem Olajuwon for career triple doubles throughout that Southwest Conference. But there's another guy that had a couple named Elvin Hayes. Listen to this. He had 45 points, 20 rebounds, and 18 blocks, Elvin Hayes did in one game. And that, those are remarkable numbers for the Big E.
Edwards can't get it to fall. Kept it alive, though. McGinnis then lays it up and in. And the Aggies, 35-27, deficit of eight for Texas A&M. Dorner, Boyd looking inside. Matt Timmy, and he hits the jumper. Timmy on average is 3.9. He's got four already. And SMU continues the heat on, back up by 10, 37-27. Murray, Broderson went for and got the board, and a foul is called. And it's on SMU. It'll be Chad Allen, the senior from Traverse City, Michigan. Been averaging 10 points a game, but only 11 total the last five games. Chad, and a timeout is called. We'll take a break. 3:56 remaining in the half. Surprising SMU up by 10.
If you've been running for years,
if you've just started running,
even if you've been thinking about running, Runner's World, the world's number one running magazine, can help you enjoy running and keep you running so you'll look and feel terrific.
Runner's World will help you lose weight fast
and show you the foods that can boost your energy.
You'll learn secrets for building speed and stamina from top runners and their coaches.
Plus, sports medicine breakthroughs and easy stretches that help prevent injury.
You can get into fantastic shape with just 20 minutes of running three times a week.
Call now and receive a free issue of Runner's World.
As a special TV bonus, you'll also receive our exclusive guide, 250 everyday health tips for runners, and a personal training log free.
If you're not thrilled with your first issue, simply cancel and owe nothing. If you love Runner's World, you'll receive a full year, 12 issues in all, plus your free tips book and training log for just three easy payments of $5.99. That's 49% off the cover price.
Call 1-800-652-2299. 1-800-652-2299.
It's tournament time for the SWC. The Horns hook up with all the hoopla in Dallas. The Aggies are aching for a win, and the Owls are eyeing a championship. Quarterfinal action continues all day, live on HSE. Check local listings.
Lady Hoopsters from coast to coast take aim at conference crowds. It's high energy and heated battles on the road to tournament glory. The SWC Championship begins Friday at noon, live on HSE.
37-27, Texas A&M on the short side against SMU. Bill Land, Jimmy Dykes, Dave Barnett with you here. Next month, join Prime from the site of the Final Four. Charlotte, North Carolina will bring you all the festivities of championship weekend from sites throughout the city. There'll be features and interviews with players and coaches, as well as former college stars now in the NBA. Join us beginning April 1st for the excitement from Charlotte. Right here, there's excitement in the Dr. Pepper Southwest Conference Classic as A&M and SMU going at it, and SMU up by 10, a team that was 6-20 in the regular season, but a victory over this A&M club in their last meeting, and trying to duplicate it. Travel on McGinnis, and the Aggies have now turned it over 9 times to just 5 for SMU.
Well, it's turned into a half-court brawl, and Tony Brony said yesterday, if it's a half-court game and the tempo is not in our favor, we stand a great chance of losing. You see right now, he doesn't like the way the first 20 minutes is going for the Aggies right now.
Broderson came out trying to help out on Dorner. Edwards back with him now. Matthews. Yeah, SMU, they've only turned it over 5 times. They have been patient enough and continue to battle on the boards. They're even on the boards as Tony Barone wondering what it's going to take to jumpstart this ball club. 3:27 remaining in the half, and Timmy going to the line. Matt's got 4, his club up by 10. A&M has never led in the ball game. And Timmy, 60.5% from the free throw line, can't hit this one. He had 4 points in the first meeting and 4 boards, 5 and 4 points and boards in the second contest against A&M. Junior from Muskegon, Michigan, 6'8", 220, and Murray brings it down, and SMU is now 6 of 10 from the free throw line. Aggs have only shot 2 and hit them both. Smith off the hand of Timmy. John Shoemate, and his ball club has won 3 of their last 5, so it's not like they're without confidence coming in here despite that ugly record.
Well, just like a lot of teams in that Southwest Conference tournament this weekend, they're playing their best basketball of the year right now, which is what you want to be doing. He's high on his ball club. He signed some kids early, and he was yesterday morning, spent some time with a junior college player that he said can make a difference in the future of SMU basketball. So he's a great recruiter.
McGinnis hits the jumper, and it's 37-29 on the deuce. He's got 6. Dorner will bring it up. Gatewood. Nice move to the hole by Gatewood over Murray. He has 9. Lead back at 10.
Well, the defense can't play behind James Gatewood when he's posting on the block. Nice shot that time by Smith, but you cannot allow Gatewood to catch it with his back to the basket within 4 or 5 feet. He's just going to jump up and shoot over you. That interior defense for the Aggies right now has to start working to get around people and quit fouling so much and giving up easy looks.
Michael Smith with his first bucket today. In fact, he hadn't scored in about a month. Gatewood. Edwards. 39-31, SMU. Broderson spins on Van Beveren, ran into a wall. Van Beveren got a piece of it, and then Gatewood, and a foul called on Texas A&M's McGinnis. McGinnis trying to come up with a loose one. And another sub as Tony's continuing to play everybody that he can find to try to give him a lift as Wills checks into the ball game now. And back the other way, Gatewood will go to the line as A&M. 10 team fouls, 2 shots the rest of the way, and SMU just 6, so they haven't put SMU in the bonus, or A&M in the bonus yet. Two. Gatewood makes it 40-31. He's in double figures with 10. As you looked at, he's not a good free throw shooter. Don't tell him that now.
Yeah, that guy right there, James Gatewood, does it all for his team. He leads SMU in minutes, field goals, field goal attempts, free throw attempts, rebounds, blocks, and steals. Anytime it takes you from one end of the floor to the other to talk about what a guy does for his team, he does a lot.
Murray hits the jumper to make it an eight-point game with his fourth point, 41-33. 1:35 to go in the half. Dave Barnett will have halftime activities for you. Stay with us. Matthews for three. Oh, mama. SMU continue to stay on it. He's got 10. It's a 12-point pony lead. Edwards got it blocked. And out of bounds, it'll go to the Aggies. Big plays both ends.
Watch Edwards take it in at 5'9". He can't have a taller defender between he and the basket. Gatewood that time goes up and meets it at the top and sends it out of bounds. A&M is really out of sync. They're tentative. They're not attacking the basket.
Van Beveren blocked Edwards again. Now Smith with a jumper, and he hits it. Michael Smith, who the last time he scored, it was February 2nd against Baylor, and he's got two buckets. It just gives you an idea. Tony Barone looking for anything he can to get this ball club going. They're down by 9, 44-35.
We'll credit SMU for controlling the flow of this basketball game. They're running that motion offense. All five guys are touching it and handling it. They're working that shot clock down. And they continued to force A&M to guard them inside. And Murray and Johnson and McGinnis, that interior defense, that post defense is not solid right now. They're gambling. They're committing fouls. And again, anytime that situation's going on, it makes for kind of an ugly style game. And that's what SMU wants.
And Murray picking up his second foul. And at the free throw line is James Gatewood. He's got 11, got a chance to get his average if he can get these two. 44-35 with 36.7 seconds remaining in the first half. 6-20 SMU up on 17-9 Texas A&M. The Aggies slide to the three-game losing string started against SMU, and SMU trying to put a finish to the Aggie season. 45-35 on the free throw by Gatewood. And Timmy comes back in. Gatewood will get a seat for the final seconds with a dozen points.
I like that. No need for James Gatewood to pick up a cheap foul with only 35 seconds to go in the half. Smart play by John Shoemake.
Murray.
I'm sorry, but you watch that SMU defense. They're packing that thing in. They'll get out and they'll shadow the perimeter shooters, which is Edwards right now. But other than that, if you look at those other four defenders, they're stacked in that lane.
There's about a second difference on the shot clock. You're looking at the game clock. Six on the shot clock. Four. And Edwards hits the three. Oh, man. What a big shot by David Edwards. He is 11th point, and it's 45-38. It makes it a single-digit lead. But the story is not Edwards and the Aggies. The story is the pesky Mustangs of SMU, who have really put together a fine first half to lead Texas A&M by 7, 45-38. We'll be back to talk about it in just a moment.
I was in town for business, and thanks to the rental car, I have time to stop by the old neighborhood. Place hasn't changed a bit.
Room for one more?
Can't beat the shoes.
Want to visit your old neighborhood? Rent from Dollar. They're right on the airport, right on the money.
Hey, it's got to be the shoes, right?
Nope, it's the rental car.
Call Dollar, the official car rental company of the NBA.
Last year, American business wasted more than $1 billion using the wrong long-distance company. Now there's a way to get that money back. Introducing MCI's $1 billion stimulus plan for American business. Get all the savings from MCI, plus we'll send you a check that doubles your savings every time you get a proof positive statement this year. Call us and put your money where it belongs, back in your business.
Because most of our flights are short, this is what our meals look like on Southwest Airlines. It's also what our fares look like. Southwest Airlines. It's just plain smart. Southwest Airlines has one of the best on-time records in the country.
Mr. Smith, you're early.
Just something to remember. Southwest Airlines. It's just plain smart.
Some people are naturally faster than others. In fact, everything they do is fast. Fast, 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 fast. Now, not everyone appreciates that. But if you're looking to get a new GM car or truck financed, fast is exactly what you want.
Mac will take care of your finance.
And the folks who arrange GMAC financing and leasing are faster than just about anyone else. GMAC, the expressway home.
You forgot your sunglasses.
Welcome back. It's halftime. Our score is 45-38. Texas A&M on the short side. Favored A&M losing to SMU in our second quarterfinal game here at Reunion Arena from the Dr. Pepper Southwest Conference Classic. And Jimmy, certainly a big surprise, but A&M, they're everyone struggling. No one got a handle on what's going on, it seems like.
Yeah, watching that first 20-minute period, you kind of get the feeling that everybody's waiting for someone else to make something happen. David Evers is trying to create some things, but even on the defensive end, they're not active, they're not alert, they're not really sharp, and SMU is not only out-executing them right now, they're out-hustling them, and that's got to be a concern for Tony Barone.
Very patient SMU team in the early going. They got six quick points, established themselves, and right away put the pressure on Texas A&M. Aggies have never led in the game.
Well, we talked about in the open the importance of SMU to knock down some perimeter shots. Matthews and Dorner have done that. As a result, it's freed up that inside attack. SMU now is going to the free throw stripe. They're not necessarily scoring on the block, but what they are doing is getting that ball to the paint, getting A&M into foul trouble, keeping this game at a slow pace, and that all favors the Mustangs.
Yeah, and A&M, on the other hand, has not gotten to the free throw line very often, but they have tried to take it inside some. SMU's been swatting them out of there.
I'll tell you what, we saw Joe Wilbert jump up and knock one down from about the 15-foot range. That's what they didn't do the last time they played SMU. They've got to step up and hit that shot. If they can do that, then Damon Johnson, Joe Wilbert, those guys inside can get their inside attack going. But right now, A&M needs one guy to say, come on, guys, we're going to win the game.
Dave Barnett will be back with halftime activities. Our score right now is SMU on top.
The most intriguing and provocative political murder mystery of the year is about to be solved in your home. Philips Compact Disc Interactive presents an alluring tale of intrigue, deception, and passion in an interactive thriller. Voyeur. You control all the action. As you make your choices, the story changes. You look into the private life of billionaire industrialist and presidential candidate Weed Hawk.
This may be the most dangerous game we've ever played.
A man will do anything to become president, and we mean anything. Voyeur, available only on CDI.
Philips CDI connects easily to your TV and plays hundreds of exciting titles for the entire family. Even with all of these features, you can own a Philips CDI for only $499. Call now for a free brochure and the location of your nearest retailer.
Twice a year during the spring and fall, we experience transmission difficulties. Due to a natural alignment of the sun, our transmission satellite, and our downlink satellite dish, the radiation emitted by the sun overpowers our broadcast signal, causing a disturbance like this. This will occur over a short period, for only minutes a day. We appreciate your understanding and continued enjoyment of the great sports seen here every day.
I've been a supervisor is that officials have to earn their way to the semifinals and to the finals just like the teams do. I don't have them to come in with any preconceived notions that you're going to work the championship game. You've got to earn your way. You've got to referee well every game if you're going to work that championship game.
How do you do this logistically? How do you keep track of this tournament and the other two that you're also in charge of?
Well, of course, the Sun Belt tournament has already been played. It was played last Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, and then the championship game was Tuesday night. So it's worked out very well for me. And today is the big day in the Southwest Conference. And with four games today, we'll have three games in the Metro tomorrow. So it's worked out very well by virtue of how it's been spread out.
We appreciate your stopping by for the visit.
It's been fun. Thank you.
All right. That is Dale Kelly, head of officiating. Halftime of game two, SMU with a seven-point lead.
Why have you chosen to live in Round Rock? It may be the schools, it may be the small-town atmosphere, or the sense of growing with a vibrant community. First Texas Bank chose Round Rock to be its home for some of the same reasons. We've been committed to serving our hometown and yours since 1972. We invite you to join the First Texas Bank family. First Texas Bank of Round Rock, locally owned and independently operated. Member FDIC.
We at David Collision Repair get more response from advertising with Table Time than any other form of advertising. We know this from our customer survey.
It's very affordable and I highly recommend it to other businesses.
Making sound decisions is the lifeblood of a small business. Turner's Furniture decided on Table Time a long time ago. Table Time works for Turner's Furniture.
Want to increase your business? Call Table Time. It's advertising that works.
Crowds, it's high energy and heated battles on the road to tournament glory. The Southland Championship, Saturday at 4, live on HSE.
Again at Reunion Arena, the SMU Mustangs, who have never won a game out of the seven seed, are 7 points up on the second seed, Texas A&M. Interesting, last year that SMU entered this tournament as the first seed. They lost to the eighth seed at TCU Horned Frogs in the first round, 72-71. Bad memories from last year. So far, good memories from the first half today. Our first half stats brought to you by Gatorade. 46% from the field for the Ponies, including four threes. 40% for A&M. They also were 4 for 9 from three-point land. Big differences from the line, where SMU is getting there 14 times and making 9. A&M one trip, and they are 2 for 2. One rebound edge for the Aggies. They've turned it over 9 times, but they have only lost 2 points off those 9 turnovers. Individually, Gatewood 12, Matthews 10, and Dorner 7, the top scorers for the Mustangs. And for the Aggies, Edwards with 11. Wilbert, 8 points. He's 3 for 7 over his last 3.5 games, 8 for 34 from the field. That's 23.5%. And they've lost the previous three, and they're losing this one at halftime. But another half to play in our second quarterfinal at Reunion Arena. Bill Land and Jimmy Dykes back in a moment.
Basketball on HSE. You're facing the action. Bang, it's got to happen.
A battle in the West. Kemp and Perkins lead a sonic boom into the summit, where Akeem, OT, and Ori lead the Rocket Front Court Thunder. The Sonics clash with the Rockets Thursday at 7:30 live on HSE.
It's time for friends to fly free on Southwest Airlines.
Wake up and smell the coffee.
And people are friendlier than ever. Just make reservations at least a day in advance and buy your round-trip ticket at Southwest's regular low unrestricted fare, and a friend flies with you, free, anywhere we fly.
Yo! Dad, what do you think?
Friends fly free on Southwest Airlines. It's just plain smart.
March Madness returns to Dallas March 9th through the 12th at the Dr. Pepper Southwest Conference Classic and Hoopla Festival. See the best of the SWC as all eight men's and women's teams battle for the 1994 championship title. And backed by popular demand is the Hoopla Festival, featuring live entertainment, food, games, and lots of fun. Stake your claim now to the best seats in the house by calling the SWC ticket hotline, 1-800-800-7928. Don't miss the Hoopla in Dallas at the Dr. Pepper Southwest Conference Classic.
And welcome back to Dallas Reunion Arena, the Dr. Pepper Southwest Conference Classic. Bill Land and Jimmy Dykes with you, and thanks to Dave Barnett for the halftime activities. We'll have a chance to take a look at the highlights here. SMU with a seven-point lead at the half, and if David Edwards doesn't hit that three, it's a single-digit or double-digit lead. One of the reasons SMU playing so well, Gatewood.
Yeah, Gatewood is getting it done inside. He's scoring right there. He's knocking down that 10, 12-foot shot, and he's going to the free throw stripe. SMU has established the inside attack this afternoon. You watch Wilbert offensively, watch the struggles right here. Nice ball fake, goes up through contact, draws the foul. Just can't get the ball to go down and form right. They've shot the ball 40 times. They only shoot 57 shots a game, A&M. They've already shot it 40 times, so they're getting the looks. Watch Dorner right here. He takes it in. I like his size for guard, his ability to jump up and shoot over defenders at 6'2". That's an added dimension that John Shumate uses in his offense. Watch the penetration right here by Allen, but the quick hands by Edwards with a strip and the steal. And he's going to the other end in a hurry. Now, here's a guy that can score points in a hurry and ignite this team in the second 20-minute period, David Edwards. He's got to get untracked in transition, and A&M's just got to get some shots to fall down for him.
So Tony Barone, as he breaks the huddle, we saw a couple of players who just have not played this year. Michael Smith had 4 points. He only had one basket for the season coming in here. He hit both his shots. Here's Joe Wilbert and the Aggies. Also, Roy Wills, who had played in just 12 games, saw a couple of minutes. On the other hand, Damon Johnson only played 2 minutes for Texas A&M. He starts the second half with Murray, Edwards, McGinnis, Chuck Henderson, and Joe Wilbert. As A&M down by 7 with the basketball, they were outscored from the free throw line by 7. That's the difference in the game. An inside pass stolen and a foul on Texas A&M's Murray right off the bat.
Well, that was a special play designed to get Brett Murray that open 18, 19-foot shot. Instead of shooting the ball, he tried to force a pass inside and committed the turnover and then the foul. That's a sign of an unconfident basketball player right there.
So Murray picking up his third foul. Dorner with a miss. Edwards with a rebound. He averages 5 boards a ball game. 5'9" guard, that ain't bad. Murray cannot hit the three. Dorner high to get the rebound. 6'2" senior from Springfield, Illinois. He's played well in the first half. Henderson slip. Boyd. Van Beveren on the backboards. And tried to keep it alive, and then a foul is called. Oh, man, Beveren's all right. Bodies flying everywhere. As you look, there's Damon Johnson in the middle of that bunch next to Tony Brody Jr. Broderson taking a seat. Johnson playing just 2 minutes, and this is a guy that has been so valuable to the program over the last few years. Junior from Converse, Texas. Leading scorer last year and rebounder. This year, his numbers at 10-5. Last year, 15-6, but only 2 minutes first half today. Murray hits the bucket. 45-40.
SMU handled the full court pressure by A&M the first 20 minutes. Did a pretty good job of attacking that press, then backing it out and controlling the tempo of the basketball game. They got to reestablish that flow here the first 4 or 5 minutes.
Boyd, Dorner. And it comes off to Joe Wilbert on the backboard. Here's Edwards. Edwards hit 3 threes in the first half on just 4 attempts. Matthews comes out on him a bit now. Murray against Gatewood. Gatewood blocked it, but a foul call. James Gatewood, who is fourth on the career block shot list at SMU, doesn't get credit for that one. Got the foul first, and he picks up his third foul. And Murray will go to the line. Brett, a transfer from Southwest Texas, senior from Longview. Started every game a year ago, averaged 9.5 points a game. Valuable player for this club. 9.6 boards a contest this year.
Yeah, in the last five or six games, he's averaging 13 points and about seven boards. So he has picked up his play when Wilbert has been in a slump, and some of those other Aggie players haven't necessarily taken their game to another level with an injured Joe Wilbert.
45-41, SMU looking for a bucket here in the second half as we're almost 2 minutes in, and they're playing a little bit tight right now. I always wonder how a team that has not expected to win will react when it's got the lead. They have not reacted favorably. Wilbert got a block by Gatewood. That's his fourth. Oh, man, that hurts the Ponies. Gatewood picks up number four. He thought he had all ball.
Yeah, that's Gatewood. That's huge because he was getting it done at both ends. He was rebounding. He was scoring. He's getting to the free throw stripe. Now they're going to have to come in with a little less talented player in Matt Timmy, and Gatewood's going to have to sit for a long spell. You're looking at 18 minutes still to go in this ball game, and he probably won't come back until about the 9 or 10 minute mark, I'm sure.
Leading scorer on the season and today with a dozen to the bench as Wilbert to the line. Edwards has a visit with him.
And Joe Wilbert is really a solid kid, a sincere kid. That incident out at Texas Tech has bothered him. The eye injury has bothered him. His high school coach was forced to resign, and he's a sensitive young man. So he's had several things kind of compound his problems here the last 3 weeks of the season.
Edwards with a steal. And A&M clawing its way back, down by three, and SMU shut out for the first 2:15 of this half. Edwards. And the little man hits the big shot, his fourth three. And David Edwards makes it a 45-45 ball game. It's the first time we've been tied since they tipped it off.
Well, there's no reason for SMU to change, though, their game plan and their strategy of attack. They've got to come down now and handle that basketball and try to reestablish what they did the first 20 minutes. They need Matthews and Donner to knock down some perimeter shots. They need to get that ball in the paint and get back to the free throw stripe.
Edwards with the foul, his first. But if you go back to the end of the first half when Edwards hit the three, it's been a 10-point run for Texas A&M. And you see the 2:45 scoreless period for SMU. Then Beveren couldn't get it. Tip won't go. Again, great left hand by Raymond Van Beveren. What a play. You talk about wanting it.
Yeah, he's really an emotional player. Kind of guy that, again, you're going to get maximum effort out of Raymond Van Beveren every afternoon.
Murray for three. Kind of a strange carom, and it ends up finally coming to Edwards. He high steps it into Murray, and a block and a foul is called again on SMU. Let's take a look at Van Beveren's effort at the offensive glass.
Yeah, just appreciate what he does here, folks at home. Watch him go up, gets the shot up. Now watch. Once, twice, and gets it to go down. It has a little emotion at the end, and that's, you got to have guys in there that can bang and just kind of get things done for 35 or 40 minutes of ball game, and Van Beveren is that kind of player. But now you've already seen the trend change here in the second 20 minutes. A&M's established that inside attack. They're getting to the free throw stripe. Things now are starting to go their way a little bit more.
Van Beveren after the second foul, sending Murray to the line. He hits one of the two, and it's 47-46 Ponies. 16:35 remaining in the basketball game. Boyd, stripped by McGinnis. It goes to Edwards, four on one. Oh, mama, hold on. Edwards gives him the lead.
A&M's got to get points out of transition. They got to trigger things defensively. They get the turnover. Again, if you're struggling on the offensive end, you got to do things with your defense to get you going, and A&M is doing it the first few minutes here of the second half.
Wilbert called for the foul. The Aggies have the lead for the first time today on a razzle-dazzle by Edwards.
Well, Edwards has all the moves in the book. Watch right here. Takes it behind his back and frees himself up. He could almost credit himself with an assist right there because he froze the defender and took it in and scored.
Edwards with 16 points for Texas A&M. And it certainly hasn't been single-handedly, but he has been the guy. And now Matthews has just been hit with a technical foul. As Matthews was going out of the game, they had subbed for him. As he went out of the game, he gave Edwards a shove. I don't know if David got in the way, but here's a look at it. I'll see you. Get out of my way. Agree or disagree with the call? Well, of course, we don't know all the trash talking that's gone on to set it up either.
A lot of times it's the second guy that gets caught, but Matthews did push as he left the field of play, and you see Shoemate not happy at all.
I think John Shoemate's saying, hey, he's a senior. He set you up, man. You got to be smarter than that. It's the end of the year. You got to be more mature than that. Don't fall for those games, if indeed there were games being played. And Matthews now, giving Edwards a shot to go to the line, makes it 49-47. And another one.
You know, I think what happened, the officials had warned both of them. Now, that's a good job right there by stepping in and say, okay, guys, enough is enough. Now, from this point on, if there's any talking, if there's any hand pushing going on, it's going to be a tee. Matthews got called. Great job of officiating.
Yep, would have to agree with the way it's been handled. 50-47, the Aggies in a wild turnaround, and Wilbert draws the foul. He'll go to the free throw line. It's been all only one basket by Raymond Van Beveren in the second half for SMU. Ponies led by 7 at the half, 45-38. It's now 50-47. They've been outscored 12-2 to start the second half.
We've got to think if James Gatewood didn't pick up that fourth personal foul quickly, he would have had a couple of field goals go down by now. That shows you the importance of Gatewood to the SMU Mustangs.
For SMU, number 32, Chris Jessen.
Wilbert. Another shot coming up. Timmy comes out of the ballgame. Jessen in. Ponies put all five there on the lane. Trying to stop this Aggie run. And Wilbert hits the second one. And Texas A&M on top by 4.
When stress takes its toll, wouldn't it be great to have your very own personal masseuse to soothe and relieve tension? When root jobs become painful, wouldn't it be great to call on a shiatsu massage therapist to melt away sore aching muscles? TheraFX presents the Pro Shiatsu Personal Massager.